Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to the YouTube channel and welcome back to this last episode of Regex Mania. And in this one, we are going to validate websites in UITextField. So without further ado, let's jump right into it. Okay, now if you are new to this episode series, then go ahead and take a look at the previous ones, and there are quite a few. We have validated age, email, and password, so go ahead and take a look at that, because we are going to jump right into the example project. And if you haven't already done so, go ahead and check out the link down below in the description where you can download the starter project, so you can follow along this tutorial series. Okay, now what we have built out in the previous video is password validation, and we needed to type in a valid password here, and this is a valid password because it has capital letters, small letters, special character, numbers. Now this is a valid password because it has capital letter, small letter, special character, numbers, and it is at least 6 characters long. Okay, now this is a strong password. Now, today we are going to implement some website validation. So let's just jump right into it. And as usual, if you are familiar with this series, let's add a validity type, case, and website. And of course, if you don't know what I'm talking about, please take a look at the previous videos, because I don't want to go through the project over and over again. We are just expanding on the previous lessons, okay? In the switch statement, we need to add another case, and I'm just going to copy this out, and let's add the case website here. And of course, we don't want to have the same regex for the password and website, so let us just create a new regex case here, case website equals to, and just an empty string for now. Okay, let's just copy that out and change this regex there. Okay, and while we are at it, let's finalize the loop by having the validity type set to website. Great, let's go back and take a look at the yummy regex. Okay, and as usual, I won't bother typing this out. I'm just simply going to copy it from our test project. And as you can see, it's quite a lot. Okay, let me just copy everything out with the comments too, okay? Because I have some good news. We are not going to have only the simple any site URL validation. We are going to dive deeper, yes. So here we have our website, and as you can see, it's quite a long and cumbersome regex. Go ahead and take a look at the expression cheat sheet in the link. Just hit command and click there. You will be taken to this awesome site page where you can take a look at the expressions. Okay, but let us just maybe go through it. And as you can see, we have some option for HTTPS, HTTP. If it's not there, here is question mark, then it's optional. We have an optional www, and here we have our body of the site URL. Now this regex is for any site URL. Okay, let's check this out, but before we do that, let me just go back to our root view controller, and as you can see in the extension, we have HTTPS and HTTP with a small letter, so it's not capital, and the www2. And in the root view controller's text field, the text field auto capitalizes, so by default. So let's set the auto capitalization type to be none. Okay, so let's build and run and see if we do get our website validated. So type in your website, https rebeloper, and dot, and here we go, com. So co would be a valid website, but we have rebeloper.com. And what if we wanted to access the blog? So we would type in news, and that is still a valid website. So go ahead and take a look at our newly created blog. Okay, and that is it. What if we wanted to add in here www? It's still a valid website, but what if we have something like, I don't really know what could make this worse, but that is it. Well, maybe I do know, not a valid website, as you can see, HTTPS. It's not working. Okay, so that is how we can validate a website with any subpages. And as a bonus, I am going to show you how to validate other types of websites. So let me just copy all of this out, because again, these are regexes and they are very, very typo prone. So there we go. Let's comment out this first one. And let's add in here our case. Okay, now any site URL with .com or .org and subpages. So if we type in here .co, that will still not work. And here is what you need to take a look at for this example. Okay, let's build and run and test that out too. Okay, rebeloper dot and SEO, CO, that is still not enough, and com, valid website, great. Now, what if we wanted to have .org? Still a valid website, but net, not a valid website. If you want to have this rule that only .com or .org or whatever type of websites you want to have validated, then this is a good regex for that. So let's comment this out and take a look at the next one. And with this one, we have any site URL with .com or .org and no subpages. Now, I didn't go into subpages in the previous one, or rather yet, let me just go into it so you may see it. Here we go in the simulator, .com and news. It's still a valid website, but if we change that and have no subpages, and this regex does just that. Let's check that out. If we type in here, rebeloper.com, it's a valid website, great, or org, it's still a valid website. Let's go with com. But if we try to add a subpage like news, our blog feed news, that is not a valid website in the way we want to set our regex up. Okay, so finally, let's take a look at another case, and that is any site URL with only .org and no subpages. Okay, here we have our org and no subpages. Okay, let's build and run finally. And now rebeloper.com will not work, only rebeloper.org. Okay, let's go rebeloper.com. It's still not a valid website. .org, valid website. Now, you could have any reason to choose any of these. I will just simply comment out this one and leave the any site URL rejects. But go ahead and combine all of these in for your use cases. Okay, now I hope you enjoyed this video about website validation in UITextfields. And of course, all of this was in Swift as usual. And I hope you enjoyed the video and the whole tutorial series. If you are new here, go ahead and subscribe to the channel. And if you like the video and hit that notification bell to get notified when I upload new videos. Now, this is the last video in our Regex Mania playlist series. Now, if you have any questions or issues about Regexes, go ahead and comment down below in the comment section. I usually answer them within 24 hours, and I really like to chat with you guys in the comment section of our videos. Now, as usual, I will see you in the next one.